From the very beginning, man has been a hunter. I too am a hunter, and I have hunted all my life. I gather flesh and bones, as my forefathers once had. A journey of pursuing the great beast of the earth. Even so, the chase is hard, for my quarry is keen to the ways of man. And I must hide and wait, taking life and giving back. It's the cycle of life. This is a hunter's journey. A relentless pursuit.
Got him! Bullseye!
So after cleaning buffalo for what seemed like an entire week, Carrie and I tried to fool an old gobbler the next morning. And we fooled him. We fooled three of them. But they weren't old. Three Jakes showed up, and boy did they put on a show. I'm using the new Avian X decoys, and obviously they work pretty good. So good that the turkeys act like they didn't even want to leave. You can tell what's about to happen. Yep, they whooped on my decoy for a while. And while a couple of them whipped on the decoy, I could hear an old gobbler in the distance, and he was coming our way. Yelped to him once in a while, and the three Jakes never even paid any attention. Heck, one of them even decided to sit down and take a nap. Meanwhile, the other two, they played a little high-o silver, and this went on for quite a while. The old gobbler never did show up, and that was that. So the next day, I figured if they came back, I'd slock one with my blowgun. I put my hen decoy a little further out in the field, thinking they'd run right over to the Jake like they did the day before. Sure enough, They strutted around for another half hour, but stayed right behind the hen decoy just out of blowgun range. They never did give me a good shot. So I'm back after them again, with the blowgun. I can hear several birds in the distance, and they're just a-ripping it. Obviously, somebody's gonna be heading my way.
Wow. I've probably got... sounds like a big tom and three or four jakes ripping it down the valley here. In the distance, I can hear a train going up the river. I'm right on the edge of the Missouri-Nebraska line.
You're watching Relentless Pursuit, America's number one bow hunting show, with me, Tim Wells, the Slock Master. And I use Morel targets, Carbon Express arrows. I buy from Bass Pro and use cold steel knives. I kill animals with Grim Reapers. I use Muzzy for big fish and wear mossy oak camo. My Oneida bow goes with me in an SKB case. I shoot Umarex air guns and fish from tracker boats. Fox Pro is my go-to call. And I drive a Ford truck, because Ford trucks are tough. I guess I was feeling a little overconfident, for I should have waited for these birds to walk right up to the decoy, but instead, I stopped one of the toms, and he gave me a standing shot. Yep, missed. Missed my mark by about a half an inch. Now, if only the dart had been a headhunter broadhead, things would have probably turned out different. Another lesson I learned a few days later was never call to the gobbler before you get your camera set up and ready. For sometimes, they'll sprint right into the decoy. I want to adjust the camera, but he's so close now I can't get away with it. And yeah, I wasn't quite ready, but either way, when he went to beating on the decoy, I came to full draw. And sure enough, I let this old tom have her. And that was it for my spring turkey season.
That's a big old tom. He just lost his noodle. And, that worked out perfect. I came right up to my decoy and knocked him for a loop. A big bird.
Well, that was a quick setup.
bird was clear down there in the bottom. I could just barely hear him gobble. I cut to him a couple times, and man, he came right up here on a string. When he saw that decoy, man, oh man.
Hey hunters, if you enjoyed today's bow hunt, go to slockmaster.com. Subscribe to my Facebook or YouTube channels. It's here that you can see all the latest adventures we've been on. Or register to win a hunt with me. You might want to even pick up a blowgun or spear. It's all here at slockmaster.com, including some of them that got away.
Ooh, still intact.